Hey guys, welcome to Neat Movie News. My name is Dean Thomas.
His name is Dean. We like Dean.
Dean. Well, that's neat.
And we have got our first Marvel movie of the year. It's Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2.
It is our duty to cleanse the universe of this weakness.
You know, they told me you people were conceited douchebags, but that isn't true at all.
Dude!
I'm using my wrong eye.
Groot, put your seatbelt on!
Now, the very first Guardians of the Galaxy was one of Marvel's biggest gambles. It was, nobody knows these characters. Is anybody going to go see this movie? It was critically praised. Audience and fans loved it. It made tons of money. So obviously, we were going to get a second movie. And because of that awesome mixtape in the first movie, we've got Volume 2 here for the sequel. So you've got the whole gang back together. You got Chris Pratt as Star-Lord, Zoe Saldana as Gamora, Dave Bautista as Drax, Bradley Cooper as Rocket Raccoon, and Vin Diesel as Baby Groot this time. And they introduce a lot of new characters in this movie as well. And I gotta say, right off the bat, I think Guardians of the Galaxy 1 is probably the better movie, but I think I had more fun watching Volume 2. This movie is a visual spectacle. It is on levels that you really don't see. I mean, this is an incredible, you need to see this movie in the theater if you want to see it, because this thing is such a huge, epic space opera, and that is really the best way to sum it up. There's so many new planets. The colors they use, it's got a very kind of rainbowy to almost at times, but there's so many different uses of vibrant colors, fluorescent colors, that it's just beautiful to look at. And you almost never really think about, oh, I can tell they're on a green screen or they're on a stage, because you can tell that often. And there's some moments here and there, but for the most part, this movie looks incredible. And all the Guardians are back, as I said, and they all bring it. Chris Pratt as Star-Lord is fantastic. But I found interesting is he's very much the main through line of this movie. Obviously, he's our main character. It's about him. But he's not on screen as much as I would have thought. And that's because they got a lot of new characters introduced and everybody's got to get their equal amount of screen time. And don't get me wrong, Star-Lord is very much present and he's on screen a lot. Just not as much as I would have necessarily thought. Rocket Raccoon crushes it once again. He's got a very big role in this movie. And Baby Groot, as you would imagine he's going to be stealing the show. And while maybe he didn't steal the show all entirely for me, he's awesome. I want more of him. I don't think we're going to get more of him, but he is so perfect. He's adorable in every way. There's so many moments of him where you just wanted it to keep going. You just wanted more focus on Baby Groot because he is just the greatest. But there was two particular standouts in this movie for me. One being Nebula, who I really did not like in the first movie. So Gamora's sister, another daughter of Thanos. Didn't really like her. Didn't really love the way Karen Gillan portrayed her. She's always like super intense and I gotta talk in this deep low voice. And it kind of is like, I didn't love the line delivery. And she does it again in this movie. And I still don't love it, but I like what happens with this character. You really get to understand her more. She gets a fair amount of screen time, but you understand her relationship with Gamora more, her relationship with her father more. You understand where she comes from and why she has the motivation she does. And I really liked everything about her character. I still didn't love the way Karen Gillan portrayed her or James Gunn directs the character per se, but I really liked the character, how it was written and kind of the motivation behind her. And the second standout is Yondu, played by Michael Rooker. I mean, he was great in the first movie. I mean, that whistle and arrow is awesome. But speaking of Nebula and getting to know more about her, you get to know a lot about Yondu, and you really get to understand him as a person, as a character completely. And he gets a lot of screen time, and I loved every second of it. He was by far my favorite character in this movie. Michael Rooker crushes it. And it's just, you finally understand a lot more about him and Star-Lord's relationship. And I just loved every second of it, because Yondu was a really cool character, but he was a Ravager. He was just kind of that secondary kind of just supporting character. But in this, he becomes much more towards the front of the group, and you understand him so much. You get his motivations. You get where he comes from. You get why he is the way he is. And I really, really thought that added to the movie a lot. Now, some of the problems here with this movie is, one, there's a few too many jokes here and there where, not that they're not funny, but it's like, it doesn't feel like there's stakes, because it's just joke after joke. But that wasn't too bad. I mean, it was just a few times here and there. I could have done without a couple of the really over-the-top kind of fake belly laughs, especially from Drax. I think he had about 18 of them in this movie. Rocket had a couple, but they were acceptable, and we kind of knew him to do that. But Drax literally has upwards of 20 giant over-the-top belly laughs in this movie. And Drax is really funny in this movie. He's got some great lines, some great moments, and Dave Bautista is really good in this role. It's just I could have done without all those over-the-top belly laughs all the time. And this movie doesn't have much of a plot, to be completely honest with you. I mean, yes, there is one, but it's not present throughout the whole movie, and it kind of comes and goes. It's much more about events that just kind of take place in the Guardians are there for, and then you get their dynamic and the relationship between the characters and how they interact when these events are going on, which is really fun. It's very much a character piece in a way, hidden in this massive blockbuster, but it's just the plot isn't so much there, and there's not much of a story. It's more of just these events that the Guardians are involved in. And I probably should mention, obviously we knew Kurt Russell is playing Ego the Living Planet, also Star-Lord's father. And Kurt Russell is really good in this. He's got a good sizable role, so Kurt Russell definitely was a very fun part of this movie. And the ending, the soundtrack was good. I didn't love all the songs. I didn't think they were as memorable as some of the first songs were in the original Guardians of the Galaxy. Although about the last third of this movie, during, you know, the third act and then the credits, I really loved there's about three songs that I was like, all right, I can definitely see myself when I hear this song thinking of this movie. So that was definitely something that I really, really appreciated. They do something really cool with the music in this movie too. They introduce a lot of new mythology and other things. There was one part in this movie where I thought they pushed the envelope a little bit too far. It's between Ego and Star-Lord in the third act. Probably pushed the envelope just a little bit too much. I mean, it's still entertaining, but it was a little out there for me. But overall, I think Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 is one heck of a fun time at the movie theater, and it should be seen at a movie theater because up on that big screen, the visuals of this movie are awesome. The colors, everything, the action, it's really, really fun to watch. The characters are great. They're back from the original Guardians. They're great. You learn more about them, and they bring their A-game to this movie. So I definitely think Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 is a worthy sequel to the Guardians of the Galaxy and also a worthy movie in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. So I'm going to rate this one at a really, really even, steady rating. I'm going to give Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 an 80%. Like I said, I think Guardians 1 is probably the better movie, but I think I had more fun watching Volume 2, and that says a lot because I had a lot of fun watching that original Guardians as well. So there you guys have it. That is my review of Guardians of the Galaxy in 80%. If you'd like to stay up to date on the latest in the world of movie news, guys, make sure you're following me on Twitter @NeatMovieNews. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you back here next time.